deranged. Call that hottie on my stage. Long week, but a great day. So it got me like sage. And on me.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Dak Prescott's Cowboys going up against Lunt's Colts.
Thank you. The heart of the Hoosier State in the Circle City of Indianapolis, Indiana, and Lucas Oil Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Between the Dallas Cowboys and the Indianapolis Colts. It's an end around with Perriman. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott, and he's able to get up here to the 26. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Prescott on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Again to Elliott. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. They go to Elliott again. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Here's Prescott. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. Prescott from the gun. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be a second down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, and they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Prescott now on second down. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. A gain of 39 that time. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Second and goal from the 2-yard line. They'll try again with Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. Stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Second down following the run. Play action. It's locked. He'll buy some time right. Caught right side. Davis. And all 26. A huge play that time for the Colts. 41 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. As they run the counter play. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. So 2nd and 10 here. Now a handoff as they run left side. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that'll make it third and 13. They'll fake it. Now Locke. And he's got his man Hilton. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. Locke able to find Hilton there for a Colt first down. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They go play action here on first down. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
Fielded about a yard deep. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
First down, Prescott. He's going to look deep down the field. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Second down, Elliott. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And an alley to run. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll try the sweep with Elliott, and he'll get nothing there. Stopped right at the line as that will wind us down to the end. Third down and 4. Try and run for it with Elliott. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
I know they want to go for it here, and I know that their fans want them to go for it, but listen, I'm going to play head coach right here and look at the facts. Tie game, plus, even if you get the first, you still got a half a field to go. I'll go ahead and punt the football myself.
Good return that time. 18 yards. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Fake here on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way, lost yardage.
No, for some reason it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized. Executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Try the right side here. And down to the 36-yard line here. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Now a handoff looking right. Room here to run. And now off to the races. Down the right side. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great effort there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Colts have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. First and 10, Prescott. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
A second down throw for Prescott. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
On third down, it's Prescott. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
One goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Call it a loss of two on the play. And it'll be third down. Now it's long. Throw right side caught by Davis. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It'll be a gain of eight, but it also lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. As they run left side, and he's able to get it to the 33, good enough for a first down. It's a gain of five on the play, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. And now here's a carry heading left, working his way for a gain of seven to the 26.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Now a handoff as they run left side. do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the two. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The first update now from a game going on in Cleveland, and it's the Browns out to the early advantage. Blake Bortles, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. Now they try the right side here, and he takes it in for a Colts score. A great play there with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year, and the Colts are able to grow their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And out now come the Cowboys. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Tenth carry now for Elliott. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Colts offense now as they make their way onto the field. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
They run the counter now on first down. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Give him 7 yards on the carry, and it will take us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this. Second down, they'll try and run the counter. He finds an opening past the 40. It's a foot race past the 20. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A big play there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Colts add on to their lead. Vinatieri now for the point after. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
A second down throw for Prescott. He's going to air one out. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
And attempted a deep ball there, and they didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. On third down, Elliott. And down he'll go at the 25. It'll be a gain of 5, and the punt team will now come out on fourth down. And another timeout taken by the Colts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. Looking left side, and it's complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. They'll get 23 yards there. And that leads to a Dallas first down. They'll pitch it out to Elliott. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Second down, Prescott. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Carry by Elliott. Oh, he shifts past him. Now a flag comes in from the umpire after a gain of about 4. And this looks like it's going to be holding. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Perriman in motion right. Prescott now. Looking deep downfield. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. He was looking for Breshad Perriman, and it's second down. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. And prior to this 3rd-and-2 play, we're going to get a timeout call, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. The Cowboys on 3rd down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This time they face a 3rd-and-2. Play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Buying time to his left. He may try and run for this. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards and a first. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
So we hit halftime. All right, folks, eager to get back to this Week 4 matchup. We won't put up a fight. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And some space here. And he's going to take this all the way down inside the 40.
Forget the idea of flipping the field. They have now put themselves in a position to score points with that big-time return.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. A handoff as they run the counter play. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be second and 12. They run the counter play. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Partner, I think there's a lesson there. Some days you're just having a really tough time, and for the defense, today has been that day. But after that play, what do you learn? You can still make plays even when the other guy's having success against you.
Locked off the bootleg, eluding the pressure right. Hard throw, incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So fourth and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. They snap it to Locke. Going for Hilton, and it's intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. Prescott now from the 50. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. They tried to swing it out left into the flat, but the defense, they were very principled there.
It felt very West Coast offense, didn't it? You know their expression, right? On a West Coast offense, when they throw the ball, it's either going to be a touchdown or a checkdown, meaning they like to press it downfield. If they don't have it, swing it out, which is exactly what we saw there. But how about the great pursuit and tackle to make a nice play?
It'll wind up being a loss of two, and they'll be facing a third and 12. Shotgun, it's Prescott. And he fires one that's intercepted. Quincy Wilson with the INT. And he's into the clear. The 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Indianapolis. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And now running right through it. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. He's going to float this one deep right side. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. The Cowboys on third down, lacking much success. Just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be third and six. Now Prescott. And this is going to be incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. Now a play fake and it's locked. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Locke. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9.
Partner, I know that ball security is preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough, and it'll be 4th down.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. That's taken on the 25. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Off the play fake, Prescott. And he'll be brought down by the Colts. Jonathan Hankins. able to use that strength and get him for a loss of two. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
Now Prescott. Throw right side to Perriman, and it's caught. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On third and one, here's Prescott. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
I like watching the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
So the offense has it first and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And oh, he is really late out that time. Knocked flat on his back around the 37. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And the wideout in motion. Prescott on first down. Now he'll escape to his right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
On second down, Prescott again. Flush to his right. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. The improv act there, good for 9. And now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Third and short yardage, Prescott. That's taken in by the rookie, Josh Malone. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
And now the offense operates in the red zone. Prescott now on second down. Flushed out right. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Prescott from the gun. That's caught out left by Perriman. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Prescott from the gun on third. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Throwing, Prescott. He almost had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted five times in their many chances thus far. This is third and 11. To throw is Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And Bailey able to knock it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So they get the field goal, but part of that was a 14-play drive to get the three.
Normally, when you hold the ball that long, run that many plays, you end up in the end zone. There's a breakdown on the defense. Something happens. In this case, that didn't. But really good ball control by the offense. They're hoping that they can wear them down if they keep having drives like that.
And the Colts getting ready to go. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. Now here on EA Sports. 8 yards to go here on second down. They'll fake it. Now Love. And he's got some space here. Caught right side, Davis. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. A big play there. Catch and run. 72 yards. So they're operating in the red zone. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, they made the play there, and I'll guarantee you their coaches and the other players are screaming at them about their pride.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great effort there. Taking it in. And the Colts are able to grow their lead. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And the Colts pick it up. And he will bring this down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble, now great field position. And now here's a carry heading left. And he is out of bounds here. A good run on first down, and now they contemplate a second and goal situation.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
And now before they run this play on fourth and one, we're going to get a break and a timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And I guess not content to get another three here late, they'll try to add six more as they go on fourth and goal. As they run left side, and he didn't get there, knocked backwards to the 2-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field, and they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3-point
kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that.
And a loose football. And the Colts pick it up.
With that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely.
And now Indianapolis set to take the field.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. Yeah, this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great play there. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Colts use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
No, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Going to throw right side here, complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Prescott looks to throw on first. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off near the 42. He's got the lane, and there he goes. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
They have gone to the fourth quarter, by the way, in that game in Cleveland. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Blake Bortles with one touchdown pass thus far. They start on the ground with Elliott. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Slot man moves right. Second down throw for Prescott. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the linebacker, Jared Davis. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. Now a play fake here on first down. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
Well, it was stopped on that play. We said plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
this is going to be incomplete.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll run it now out of the gun. They find some open field here. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. It's a gain of 8, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. Now a handoff looking right. And he's going to go backward. They get him behind the line. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Well, Chuck Pagano, he's told his offense, stay out there. We're going for it. And now they'll run it here off tackle. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. Chuck Pagano decides to go. It doesn't work out. And the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
no,
again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
On play action, Prescott steps away to his left. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Again, it's Elliott. Space to maneuver at the 40. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. So here we go, first and 10 now. So the D-line's going to spread out. A 20th carry here for Elliott. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
One last shot now for Prescott. And that's caught inside the 30. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory.